Dear fellow and friends, we talk about the COVID-19 pandemic as a system crisis. We discuss its multiple field impact, but we fail to discuss its impact of the most important actors within the people. It is highly important to be aware that the debate of the pandemic need not be only about states and other actors. It needs to be first and foremost about the people. We often speak of industries collapsing, but we fail to see that the people are the very first victims, and they are altogether the very industries. It has been interesting to have a look at the spirit of conformity manifested by billions of people around the world who decided to play safe and follow the rules of the state of emergency imposed for a greater goal, that of surviving. The stress caused by a veritable house arrest of billions of people will leave deep traces and will affect both our generation and that of the younger one. An efficient psychotherapy needs to begin with understanding the very essence of the phenomenon. The paralyzing effect of the pandemic on social and economic life stemmed from the generalization of fear. The unemployed, homeless people, as well as the CEOs of great companies, presidents, the prime minister, have been equally affected. Let us not forget that this generalized fear was among the roots of all totalitarian regimes. When the ICU doctors, specialists in infection disease, pneumologists, virologists placed in the front line of their fight with COVID will have ceased their mission, they will be replaced by the psychiatrists. At the end of the terrible calamity that was the Second World War, the wrecking havoc was imposed not just on economy, but also on human souls. After the tragedy of the Titanic 100 years ago, a common universal call for help was agreed upon, SOS. Save our soul. 60 years ago, our academy was created by great scientists who understood very well the extent of damages that can be caused by wrongly used performances of science and technology, but also the human drama experienced by people worldwide, be they from defeated or the victors' countries of the Second World War. Maybe this was the reason why they named it the Academy of Art of Science, because art and literature can better heal human souls. In the portrait of Dorian Gray, there is a remarkable sentence: to heal your souls through senses and your senses through resort to one's soul. That Oscar Wilde adds to that the soul is a terrible reality. It can be sold and bought. It can be poisoned or perfected. I might add to that the soul can also be bought back. Those who are about to lose hope need to be reminded that a higher life goal can free one from fear. It is because of that that during this pandemic, the debate was centered on human rights and the moral values that guide our life. This is why I strongly believe that this is the best time to act and we need to act now. It is high time that the academic milieu took a stand and mastered the debate on what can be done to overcome the crisis for the years to come and the generations to follow. Thank you.